a scientist from Masbate is this year's Binibining Pilipinas International. Filipino-Australian Hannah Arnold bested 33 other candidates in the Binibining Pilipinas competition Sunday night. In the question and answer portion, Arnold was asked whether she believes genuine freedom of speech exists in the Philippines. And here's what she said.
First of all, freedom of speech is a basic human right that we all must remember. And it is important for a democracy. And with our upcoming election, we definitely need free speech. For example, on Twitter, we are limited to few characters. And what I have seen from these tweets has been powerful and has helped me think about who I would like to vote for in the upcoming election.
Arnold will represent the Philippines in the Miss International pageant later on this year. Binibining Pilipinas was formerly the home of the local Miss Universe franchise until the establishment of the Miss Universe Philippines organization in 2019. An experience of a lifetime. That's how British billionaire Sir Richard Branson described his trip to space. Branson and three other members of Virgin Galactic's VSS Unity earned their wings Sunday after a successful flight to the edge of space. This as Branson hopes to usher in an era of space tourism with Virgin Galactic, the company he founded in 2004, poised to begin commercial operations next year.
I was once a kid with a dream, looking up to the stars. And now I'm an adult in a spaceship looking back to our beautiful Earth. To the next generation of dreamers, if we can do this, just imagine what you can do.
Branson's fellow space tourism pioneers are congratulating the British billionaire for Virgin Galactic's historic feat. On Instagram, Amazon founder Jeff Bezos said that he cannot wait to join the club. Bezos plans a similar trip to the edge of space in 9 days aboard a rocket from his own company, Blue Origin. SpaceX boss Elon Musk also tweeted his congratulations. Musk was among the guests during the launch of Branson's space flight.